These are lying little bastards. Hey guys, you have been lied to by these. These are Zigbee thermostatic regulator valves or radiator valves, however you want to call them. These in particular are Zigbee, and I've talked about them in this video here. If you want to know more and how to control them, then click through and you're gonna find out. But in this video, I'm gonna tell you why these are lying to you and how to fix it with auto-calibration script. It doesn't take a genius to figure out that if you have an internal temperature sensor on one of these and you place them next to the radiator, well, you're going to get some false readings. And, well, there is a problem with that. And don't be fooled into thinking that offset that you can set on these units to calibrate it for external temperature will fix your problems. No, it won't. It will average the problem and shift it elsewhere. So why is that? Any source of heat will radiate more heat the hotter it gets. Now, this progress isn't linear. It's more looking like an exponential curve. So when you compare both curves together, you quickly realize that you're trying to calibrate exponential curve of the heat radiation with a linear offset. You probably did the right thing and set the calibration offset when the radiator was hot, meaning that at the hottest point, the temperature, internal temperature of the sensor was showing you the exact temperature of your room. This means that as soon as you stop using your radiator, the temperature will drop below the temperature of your room. Now that you know the theory, let's do some testing to back it up and then we'll write a script. Since I've got two units, I can easily test this out in my first scenario by applying offset to one of the TRVs, leaving the other one without offset applied to it. Then I'll place both devices next to the radiator so they could catch some heat bleeding from the radiator. And I'll monitor the temperature over the course of a couple of days. In addition to that, I also put an additional sensor next to it so I could compare the temperature sensors from internal TRVs with a third-party solution, and I'll also have another sensor in the room indicating the overall temperature of the room, something I will strive to calibrate against. This is my room temperature over the last couple of days. And you'll see that if I'm gonna add the TRV without offset, that's how the graph looks like. Each time the radiators aren't working, it's pretty much on point with small deviations. Now, when the temperature rises because the heating is enabled, you can see a massive shoot of the temperature, and it's probably misreporting about 6 to 8 degrees. So you can see those spikes in here. So this what happens to your TRV when it's not calibrated. So how does it look like when you actually calibrate your TRV? It's very easy. We can just switch to my second one, and that's how it looks like when you calibrate. So I've applied calibration of 3 degrees at first in here. You can see that already it's working, and because the reporting temperature is 3 degrees lower when the radiator isn't working. Now, I came up with this number because I wasn't sure how high I'm supposed to be using this. Now, you'll see that this is perfect calibration spot in here when the room temperature and the temperature from TRV intersects. Now, what happens is, if the radiator goes very hot, now that despite the calibration, well, it's not much is going to happen because that's still, it's not going to be calibrated well enough. So I've changed the, I let it cool down, and I've changed the values in here for another 5 degrees. So you can see once applied, and I got next readout, the temperature was spot on again. But as the room was cooling down, the temperature dropped off below the actual average. In the NodeRED, it's very simple again. In this flows in here, I'm simply sending the temperature to my database and displaying it on Grafana. I'm not doing anything special apart from this node, which temporarily suppresses updates. I'll explain why. Now, when I read the temperature from my home sensor, I calculate the offset. This basically compares the time which the temperature was taking against the last calibration or last temperature time, and then there's a little bit of mats in here. Now, if I have met both conditions, so if my calibration temperature is within the range and the time it wasn't that far away, in this case 15 minutes, then the calibration temperature is being sent back to my thermostatic radiator valve. What happens then is, because that thermostatic radiator valve will update me back through this channel with a new offset, however, with the temperature reporting with old offset, I can't really take this in consideration and I have to suppress that message. It happens instantaneously. So I've added a 10 seconds delay to be sure, and that last node ends the suppression. That way, that only value isn't taken in consideration in terms of updating my database. And with the next update from the radiator, I'm going to get a fresh value with a fresh offset adjusted as required. All right, let's run the same scenario with TRV that has been auto-calibrated versus the TRV that has been used with calibration offset. Now, this is the room temperature of a couple of days. And you can see if I add the TRV that was calibrated with an offset set when the heater or radiator was at high, the offset was almost 8 degrees, and as such, as soon as the radiator is off, the offset is considerably below the temperature in the room, which is highly inaccurate. Now let's take a look at the data from the TRV that has been auto-calibrated against the temperature sensor in my room. As you can see, for the most part, it just follows the room temperature and it adjusts itself as needed. And it works for both scenarios, when the heating was on and when the heating was off, showing you that the auto-calibration system works. I'm actually pleased with the results. I've left them running for a couple of days, and now all I have to figure out is what is the best temperature sensor that I could use for this setup. I'll be aiming to find a temperature sensor that report rate is high enough, so each time this device requests a calibration update, the fresh temperature from the room will be available. One of unintended advantages of using this setup is the fact that you can use any temperature sensor, even one located in a different room, just in case the TRV isn't located in the same room, which might be the case, especially if you have a floor heating. I still only have two of these and I'm waiting for another 9 to arrive. This means that as soon as this happens, I can start working on my smart home heating version 4.0. Now, if you want to find out what my 3.0 is capable of, and I'm telling you it's really, really cool, then there's a video there for you explaining everything in V3.0. So if you are interested in these and you want to upgrade your own heating system at home, then I'll leave the links to these in the description of this video. You know, I do not have a posting schedule, so if you want to find out what's next and when the actual V.40 is coming out, well, you know how YouTube works. I am not going to explain you this, but what I would really recommend you to do is to follow me on any given social media for two reasons. First, you'll be able to leave unmoderated comments. YouTube often moderates those, especially if you include any links. Unfortunately, I don't have access to these and, well, you might not hear from me back. Second reason is, obviously, if you follow me on social media, you'll get to engage in a conversation and find out about all the projects I'm working on currently. As for now, guys, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.